Okay. Okay, so let's start from pH. We all know very basics of the pH, right? What does it mean? The power of hydrogen ion, correct? Potenz, actually the pH word comes from the potenz, right? That is the German word and it means power. Power of hydrogen ion, okay? So what is like pH? What is the, what is the significance of pH? So first of all, we have a scale which is known as pH scale. Right? And it clearly tells us about the characteristics of the solution, of any solution. Okay? This scale measures 0 to 14. 0 to 14. If suppose we have pH from 0 to 1, which we are going to discuss in further few slides. If we have pH 0 to 1, then it is, 0 to 7, then it is what? Then your solution is acidic, right? Then 7 to 14, solution is alkaline or a base. Guys, please don't unmute. You can send me your answers in chat box, okay? And don't worry, we have a very long class. We are going to discuss so many questions. So be ready for answers, okay? Be ready with your answers and everything. But please don't unmute right now. Okay, now pH 7. If suppose we have pH 7 for our solution, what does it mean? That is neutral. The best example of neutral solution is what? Water, correct? So pH we have in the form of pH scale, pH paper, right? pH paper which we dip in the solution and then according to color, we decide the solution is acidic, neutral or basic, right? That also we are going to discuss. pH paper is a paper which is used to measure the pH or which is used to identify the nature of solution, right? Okay. Next. Now, important thing, the strength of acid or base. So we know very well, we have a strong acid, weak acid, strong base, weak base, and all those things, right? What does it mean? Strong acid gives rise to the more H plus ion, correct? Or a strong acid dissociates completely, almost completely. For example, HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, but weak acid gives rise to less hydrogen ion. Or I should not say that give rise to less hydrogen ion, but weak acids are what? Weak acid, that means if you have less hydrogen ion in your solution, that means the particular acid that is weaker, right? The best example is what? Acetic acid. The formula of acetic acid is CH3COOH and carbonic acid, okay? Next, strong base, the same thing. If your base dissociates almost completely, now you must be thinking, ma'am, what does it mean by almost completely? What is the extent of that? So it dissociates almost 99%, 99.9% also it's possible. Okay. So that means a strong base and weak base. That means just that approximately 10%, 10%, 12%, 15% like that. Okay. Approx values. The example of weak base is what? Ammonium hydroxide. Okay. Now let's discuss the pH of saliva and lemon juice and some cold drinks, carrot juice and all those things. Now here I need answers from you. What is the pH of saliva before meal? What is the pH of saliva before meal? Aryan Tandon, very good. 7 to 7.5. Okay, so approx pH value, I will write here 7.4. The pH of saliva before meal is good. Okay, Akshita. Akshita Navya, yes. 7 or something. Yes, it's approximately 7.4. Okay. pH of saliva after meal. Aryan is saying 5 to 7. Okay. 5 to 7. Isn't it a very big range? Andrila, I'm pronouncing your name correctly, is it? Less than 7, what I know. Okay. Okay, thank you, beta. So yeah, obviously, yes, it's less than 7 beta, but you have to be give me the approx value. Aniket Gupta, you there? Add in. What is the pH of saliva before after meal? Akshita, very good. Akshita, sorry, Akshita, very good. Add in Aryan, Shobita is there, Momita is there, Neha. Aryan M. Aryan, is it Aryan Mehta? Aryan M. Are you Aryan Mehta? Okay, Vita. Yes, good guys. Correct. So pH of Arushi. Good. Very good. pH of saliva is what? 5.8. Okay, it's 5.8. Obviously, the nature of substance would be what? Acidic. Right? Right? Okay. Next, the pH of lemon juice. I'm talking about pure type of lemon juice, okay? Meghna, okay. Aryan, okay. Ralph, okay. Ralph is more about to correct. Meghna is also correct, okay. Neha, okay. Sarita, okay. Ranjini, Ritika, Momita. Yes, okay, guys, yes. So the pH of lime juice is 2.5, approximately 2.5. Okay, now guys, you have to do this table because it is in your NCERT textbook, right? So you have to learn all these pH. Okay, so don't get confused. You can write approx value, but try to be more perfect. Okay, try to write more perfect. So instead of just 2 to 3, you should write 2.5. Okay. Yes, Surya, beta, it's very necessary. It's very important. You have to memorize it. Lime juice pH, they have asked in past year question. Tomato juice pH, they have asked in past year question. 1 molar NaOH, they have asked in past year questions. Okay, that's why I have included this table from your textbook. The same table is given, I guess, the page number 26, if you've seen, and the same table is there. Okay, so whatever you have in your textbook, we have to do. Okay, yes, next. Akshita, correct. Okay, Momita, yes, correct. Next, what we have, colorless, what? Aerated drink. Colorless aerated drink. Fine. What is the pH of colorless aerated drink? I'll just give you one clue, okay? It's slightly acidic. No, Meghna, it's too less beta. No, it's slightly acidic, I'm saying. Slightly. No. Think and answer. Very good. Very good, Surya, Akshit, Andrila, correct. It's, yeah, six, you can say six. Okay. The pH of what I was saying. Yes, pH of colorless aerated drink is approximately six. Okay. 6.5 is fine. Okay. Yes. Next, carrot juice. My son loves carrot juice. Okay. What is the pH of carrot juice? Again, a clue. Carrot juice is also acidic. Not the one which we drink, okay? The sort of more purified sample. It is also acidic, not very strong, but medium to weak acid. Carrot juice pH is 5.6. Okay, you can write 5.5 also, no problem. 5.6. Oh, wait, I have written 5.5 once again. Yes, okay. Coffee, E, coffee pH. Five, nahi, Meghna, it's too less beta. Nah. Coffee is also acidic. Nah. No. Coffee is acidic, guys. Yes, its pH is six. Okay, approximately 6.5 is also fine. No problem. So the students who have recently joined, please take the screenshot of this table especially, okay? If you have not written all of these things now, then please take the screenshot, okay? Yeah? Okay, next we have tomato juice. Tomato juice is slightly acidic, moderate to moderate acid, I should say. Oh my God, Akshita, you have learned all, huh? Good, very good. So not tomato, tomato juice is 4.1. Good. Then we have tap water. Tap water pH is neutral. Now, 7, correct. Meghna, it's slightly acidic to neutral. Okay, so tap water, now you can write somewhere in between 6.9 or 7. Wait, coffee is 5.6. What I have written? One second. Coffee is 6 actually. And tomato juice is 4.1. And tap water is 6.9. You can write 7. No problem. Okay. Okay. Now next we have NaOH. NaOH is a strong base. 1 molar NaOH, very strong base. Very strong base. What should be the pH? Momita, right. Akshita, correct. Very good. Saloni, yes. Fine, correct. Surya, correct. Okay. So guys, listen, if you see 1 molar NaOH or 1 molar HCl, 1 molar H2SO4, okay, 1 m, this means the concentration, okay, molar concentration. Okay. So 1 molar NaOH, 1 molar HCl, whatever acid base, if it is available in this amount, that means they are talking about very strong acid or a strong base. Okay. Okay, so NaOH pH is 14 and 1 molar HCl pH is? Meghna, very good, good. 0. Saloni, bit at 0. Okay, Ananya, Namish, yes. Ranjini, Ghosh, good. 0. Okay, Aryan Gupta, are you there in the class? Ishika Patidar, correct. Ritika, correct. Vaishnav, correct. Good, correct. Surya, where they have given, have they given 1 molar HCl, beta?
Ma'am, under the heading gastric juices, it says it's about 1.2.
Okay. No. Listen, gastric juice is a little bit diluted. Okay, so pH has slightly increased. Okay, the 1 molar, that's why they have given in the special concentration in your textbook, 1 molar HCl. The pH of 1 molar HCl is 0. Okay, if you dilute it, what will happen? The hydrogen ion concentration will decrease. Then pH will increase. Okay, yeah. Okay, Aryan, please remind me to discuss this doubt better in the end of this class. Okay. Because this is not related to our, the CBC portion now. So I don't want to waste the time right now because, you know, we have so many slides remaining. Okay. So please remind me in end of the class. Don't forget. Okay. Next we have pH scale. Now we all are very well aware of the pH scale. Then why I have included this? You know why? Because I just wanted to show you the colors. Okay. See, if you have neutral, one second. Yeah. Some student want to come, but he's not able to join. What's happening? I don't know. Just give me a second, beta. Okay. So why I have included this pH scale, just wanted to show you the colors. If you have very strong base, then what you have to, what will be the color of the strong base? It's approximately blue, dark blue, right? Dark blue. If you have a strong acid, then the color of pH should be orange red or reddish orange. Okay. Okay. And if you have neutral, then it should be pure mehndi green color, I should say. Okay. Right. So in the upcoming slides, we will see some questions which have came in 2015, 16, 17. I don't remember the exact year. You will see they're asking about the color of the pH paper for maybe NaOH solution, or I don't remember exactly which solution they have given. If the color of pH paper you are getting very dark blue, that means the solution is sodium hydroxide. Okay, solution is sodium hydroxide. If the color of pH paper you are getting orange to red, that means that is your gastric juice or H2SO4 or HCl. Okay. Okay. So need to keep that thing in your mind very clearly, very carefully. Next. Okay, next we have pH of solution, or pH of solution. Instead of that, I have to write importance of pH in our everyday life, right? So, you know, in our stomach produces hydrochloric acid, right? It helps in digestion of food without harming our stomach. True, right? What is the reason how HCl can't harm our stomach? Very good, Meghana. Correct, because of the mucus layer, right? We have a thick layer of mucus. Yes, yes, correct. Good, guys. So when the stomach produces too much of acid, it causes pain, right? Pain, irritation, feeling of like burning sensation. Okay, so this stage is called acidity. To get relief from this pain, what doctor suggests us to take antacids, right? Or to take that Eno, because Eno contains sodium bicarbonate, correct? Sodium bicarbonate is also basic. It gives us relief from the over acidity or acidity, I should say. So doctor prefers us to take the antacid. Any example of antacid? Jellicil is fine, Surya, but I need the content of Jellicil. You guys know, yeah, don't tell me. Aniket. Yes, yes, guys, correct. Milk of magnesia or MgOH twice, okay? Milk of magnesia or MgOH twice, correct. Milk of magnesia, MgOH twice, aluminium hydroxide, those are the example of? Okay, example of antacids, correct. NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate is also the example of antacid, correct. No problem. Okay, yeah, magnesium hydroxide. Guys, oh, I forgot, it's written here only. Yeah, so magnesium hydroxide, this is known as milk of magnesia. This is a mild base and also used for this purpose. Which purpose? For to reduce the acidity in stomach, correct. So pH of acid rain, you know, when the first rain comes after that after summer season. Yeah, after summer season. So that rain usually, I have heard that the rain is acidic rain. Why? Because the rain, the water of the rain reacts with atmospheric pollution. What kind of pollution now? Atmospheric gases like sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, okay, and it converts into sulfuric acid and carbonic acid and even nitrogen dioxide also. Not carbon dioxide, because that is not that much reactive. Okay, nitrogen dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and it converts into nitric acid and sulfuric acid. Okay, so which gets mixed with the rainwater and reduce the pH of water up to 5.6. So if the pH of rainwater decreases up to decreases less than 5.6 or up to 5.6, that is known as acid rain. Right? Acid rain. 5.6 is acid rain. Called acid rain. Okay. So when this acid rain flows into the river or into the soil, what will happen? It will definitely going to affect the aquatic life, right? Aquatic life, plant life, because the body of aquatic animal also can survive at the normal pH. They have certain pH range. Okay. They can't survive in acidic pH. Okay, the same thing is applicable for plant as well. We will see in the next slide. Yeah, it's here, correct. The pH of soil, pH of soil and plant growth, yes. So the soil with higher peat content or iron content, like iron minerals, okay, or with higher, with high rotting vegetation, tend to become acidic. The soil which has higher peat content, iron mineral, rotting vegetable content. So the pH of soil will decrease. Okay, it will become acidic. One second, somebody. Yeah, it will become acidic. So it might fall even less than 4. Okay, so this acidic effect can be neutralized by liming of soil, right? We have learned it, correct? So this acidic effect of the soil can be neutralized by liming of soil. What does it mean? We can add calcium hydroxide or calcium oxide or powdered chalk into the soil, okay? Which will increase the pH of soil and it will be maintained approximately 7, right? Okay, now if suppose by mistakes, any farmer has added too much of lime, then what can we do? Too much of this calcium hydroxide powder. Then what can we do? Aryan, add vinegar. Okay, good option you have given, but Akshita, yes, correct. Correct, yes. So if the pH of soil raised to 8.3, okay, then what can we do? We can add some organic matter. Or even it is up to 8.3 also, it is not acceptable. Okay. So this can be reduced by adding organic decaying matter or decaying organic matter. Decaying. Guys, is this pen color fine? Is this color of pen fine? Decaying organic matter. Okay, so which reduces, this is, what should I say? This is acidic in nature, so it will reduce, it will maintain the pH of your soil. Okay, next. Our body functions in between the pH range of 7 to 7.8. Okay, in living organism. And you know, this is very narrow pH range. So we also have to maintain the pH approximately 7 to 7.8. That is again another significance of pH, right? Okay, now this is very important point. The tooth decay and pH. How tooth decay is related to pH? We all know very well that the teeth enamel is made up of insoluble calcium phosphate. Teeth enamel is made up of insoluble calcium phosphate. Okay, which is very hard, which is quite hard. So when pH of mouth falls below 5.5, the enamel gets corroded. The enamel gets corroded. It reacts with acid and then get dissolved into the acid. Okay, so the bacteria present in the mouth break down the sugar to lactic acid. That also increases the pH of, that also increases the acidity of mouth, right? And the formation of this acid causes decrease in pH, right? So that is why it is advisable that whenever we eat food, whenever we eat some sugary food or something, we always have to clean our mouth, okay? So that bacteria cannot degrade sugar and they cannot convert sugar into lactic acid. So pH of mouth should be balanced, right? It would be balanced then. Yeah. Now, how can we prevent it? How can we prevent tooth decay? Simple, by using toothpaste after each meal or after having sugar, after having some chocolates, right? Yes, so the toothpaste contains some basic ingredients, which helps neutralizing the effect of acid and also increases the pH of mouth, okay? Right? Aryan has asked me one question. Is the calcium salt formed as the result of neutralization or to use as the plant? Okay, no, Aryan, basically why we are using calcium hydroxide or the basic content, because it reduces the H plus ion concentration in the soil. Okay, it reduces H plus ion concentration in the soil. That's our aim. Oh my God, gypsum. Seriously, no, Neha, gypsum is very less reactive. We can't use it. Okay, when we will read that gypsum reaction and all that, then remind me, I'll explain this question. Okay, yeah, next. Bee sting or stinging hair of nettle leaves. What they do, they inject methanoic acid in our skin, right? Which cause pain, irritation, correct? So when we use weak base like baking soda, so we'll get relief, correct? That means what? Bee sting or the hair of nettle leaves, they contain methanoic acid. Methanoic acid is also known as formic acid, right? Formic acid. So don't get confused. Okay, yeah. Aryan, yes, there particular reason though. Yes, beta, because the reactivity, okay, the reactivity of calcium hydroxide is important. Okay, so once we discuss the gypsum thing now, we will discuss why we are using lime or that calcium hydroxide, why we can't use gypsum. Okay, yeah, next. Yes, you know what, the hair of nettle leaf contains methanoic acid, correct? And then this plant is actually have seen in the wild areas, correct? You know, if suppose you get touched by this plant or the hair of this plant, definitely you are going to feel irritation. What is the solution? In the that wild area, you are not going to get sodium bicarbonate. And suppose you don't have sodium bicarbonate, then what will you do? Yes, Surya, dock plant, correct. So nature itself has given the solution to us, right? There is a traditional remedy. Is rubbing an area of that pain area with the leaf of dock plant, which often grows beside the nettle plant, okay, in the wild area. So why? Now, what is the content of dock plant? Like, what does it contain? Obviously, because it is neutralizing the effect of methanoic acid, that means the dock plant containing should be containing some base, right? Basic ingredient, okay? So dock plant contains a basic ingredients which helps to neutralize the formic acid. Okay, yes, please read this thing properly, okay? This is also given in NCERT textbook only, but I don't remember the page number. Now we have a question, very easy question, right? 2012 and then repeated in 2014. Write the name of write the name given to base that are highly soluble in water. Waiting for your answer. Correct, correct, correct. So water soluble bases are known as what? Alkali. Very good. Guys, only alkali is not enough, okay? Alkali is the answer till here. Give an example. You have to write example. Either KOH, NaOH, anything is fine, okay? Yes, yes, you have to mention. Otherwise, definitely you're going to lose half mark. This question is for 3 mark, okay? Water soluble base, what I was talking about, yes, water soluble bases are called alkalis. Example, NaOH, KOH. Okay, next, how do tooth decay related to pH, how can it be prevented? So this was the answer for A. Now for B. You can write in short if you want. Yes, yes, correct, correct. Oh my God, Aryan Tandon, very good speed. Good, Shobita. So how to write it and what are the keywords? Tooth decay starts when the pH of mouth gets lower than 5.5. Okay, so tooth decay starts when the pH of mouth decreases or when the pH of mouth is lower than 5.5, right? What is the exact question? How tooth decay is related to pH? Okay, yes. Now, you have to mention, see, how tooth decay is related to pH, right? So here you have to mention the, what should I say? Tooth decay starts when the pH of mouth is lower than 5.5. Why? Because in the acidic medium, the tooth enamel starts corroding, okay? Start dissolving in it. Acidic medium. Tooth enamel, one second, oops, what's happening? Guys, just give me a second, okay? Yeah, 2 ml. Gets corroded. Varsha, very good, beta. Gets corroded and causing tooth decay. Very good. Causing tooth decay, which can be prevented by cleaning the mouth and teeth using toothpaste. And teeth using toothpaste . Okay, now cleaning the mouth using toothpaste is not enough. Okay, cleaning the mouth and teeth using toothpaste, preferably after each meal or after having sugary food. Okay, after having sugary food. Done, right? The next question, next part of the question was C, I guess. Yeah. Why does bee sting causes pain and irritation? Rubbing baking soda. You know very well how to write. Oh, ma. Aryan and Neha. Very good, beta. Shobhita also. Nice to see your interest. Good. Let me just go through. Bee sting contains methanoic acid, causes pain and irritation. Baking soda and nature the neutralizer. Very good. Correct. Correct. Yes. Good, guys. Yes. So we can write the same thing. Okay. I'm just going to copy your answer only because it's absolutely fine. So answer for C. Okay. One more answer has came. Yes. Bee stings contains formic acid or methanoic acid. Formic acid or methanoic acid, okay, which causes pain, or irritation. Dropping baking soda on the bee sting area gives relief. Why? So the rubbing baking soda is basic in nature. Baking soda is basic in nature, which neutralizes the acid, right? Basic in nature. So it neutralizes the acidic liquid ejected by bee sting. Injected by bee sting. Okay. And gives relief. Done? Okay. Good. Very good. Next question.
Ma'am, I have a doubt. Can I please ask before we move on?
Ma'am, who is this?
Ma'am, I'm Akshita. I've messaged the doubt to you personally. If you can please check.
Wait, I'll check, Akshita. Akshita, can you please copy and paste again? Because I'm not able to see your message. it's not appearing in my phone. Okay. Akshita, okay. See, Akshita is asking one thing, that non-alkali bases cannot be dissolved in water. How do we see their basic properties? Do they still produce OH negative ion? Very good question. So, Aiden, are you there? Aiden, are you there? Can you explain Akshita's question? Can you explain to Akshita for this question? Mm-hmm. Try. Aiden, I know that you know the answer. Yes, Aiden, I'm waiting. Aryan Tandon, do you have any answer for this? Aryan Tandon. Okay, Andrila, no problem. Okay, wait, I couldn't see the message. 1 minute. Where is the... Yes, Shreyas, correct, it's true, okay? See, Akshita, Shreyas, and all of you, please listen to me. See, bases only, they don't have only one property that they show OH negative ion. It's not that if you have only H plus ion, then only it would be acidic. If you have only OH negative ion, then only it would be acidic. No. Okay. They have other more properties. Like, let's say ammonia, NH3. You know what? When it reacts with water, what happens? When it reacts with water, it takes H plus ion from water. So what it is forming? NH4 positive. Now, what it is giving in the solution, what it leaves behind, NH4 positive and OH negative. Again, this, the presence of OH negative indicates what? Basic characteristics of this ammonical solution, right? Okay. So, because they neutralizes the acid, that's why they are the base. Okay. They are not only the base because they have OH negative ion. No. Or they are not only the base because they produce OH negative ion. Right? So the important definition, what you need to keep in your mind, that bases neutralizes acid, first thing. Second, base accepts proton. If they accept proton also, that means that is a base. Okay? Or if they donate electron, that means these are the bases. Okay? No, Anish, who told that they have to be dissolved? They have to dissociate, simple. Okay. Like, let's say any metal oxide. Okay. Which oxide you will take? Calcium oxide. How does it form calcium? Why calcium oxide is a base? Because calcium oxide forms calcium hydroxide, which after reacting with water, it releases OH negative ion. Right? So the calcium oxide tends to the formation of OH negative ion, right? And the properties of the base is not only depending upon the release of OH negative ion. It depends upon two other things, right? INR guys and YPR guys, if you remember that we have learned the theories, Arrhenius theory, Bronsted-Lowry theory, and one more is there. CHK guys, you should also remember that, right? One more theory is there. Which one? Lewis theory, which says that what all the compounds are bases. Okay. Yes, Anish, the non-soluble bases, that means the base which react with acid to form salt and water. Those compounds will be base. If they don't produce OH negative, that is fine. Okay. Disha, dissociation is not necessarily required in water. It can happen with acidic medium as well. Okay? Yeah? Good. Okay, let's do this question quickly. Okay. Akshita, hope you are done, beta. If still you have doubt, na, you can ask this doubt in the Centum forum or you can ask me personally. Okay, if you are in the that student group, just post your doubt over there personally. I'll send you some document related to this. Okay. Okay, good. Akshita, you are not in the group. Then how are you getting the link from the Learnist? Oh, no, Edin, I don't know. I don't think she is there in the group, WhatsApp group, in the Mockstra also. Akshita, from which school are you, beta? Yeah, I know. Okay. You're from DPS. Then how will you get to... okay, then I'll tell you the process of the posting doubt in the Centum forum. Okay, you can post a doubt in the Learnist. Okay, there is a separate doubt group actually. Yeah, okay, good. But is this clear? Like what you have asked, is this clear now? Okay, chalo. Guys, now let's see this question. State the reason of following. Dry HCl does not change color of the dry. 1 second, something went wrong again. Oh, so many answers. My God. Wait. I'm not able to see your answers. Good. Okay. Very good. All of you know the answer, yeah? Yes, dry HCl does not contain hydrogen ion in it. So it does not show any acidic behavior, right? Yes, good. Correct. So dry HCl does not contain. Okay, guys, meanwhile, you send me answer for the next one. Alcohol and glucose. Okay, for that, you send me the answer, okay? Try HCl. Does not contain any hydrogen ion in it. So it does not show any acidic behavior. Any acidic behavior. And what they have are dry HCl gas. Dry HCl gas. Yeah, okay. Next. Alcohol and glucose. Excuse me. Alcohol and glucose also contains hydrogen, but do not conduct electricity. Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh my God. So many answers again. Good. Yes. Alcohol and glucose do not conduct electricity because they don't dissociate into water, right? This was the question of 2014. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Disha, sort of right. Okay, wait, I'll write the correct answer here. Wait. The aqueous solution of alcohol and glucose, aqueous solution of glucose, and alcohol do not show electricity. Oh, sorry. 1 second. Khushi has entered. Yeah. do not conduct electricity because conduct because of the absence of free ions or absence of free electron, because absence of free ions or free electrons. Okay, now please pay attention. Aqueous solution of glucose and alcohol, they dissolve in water, right? But they don't dissociate into ions. That's why they don't conduct electricity. Okay, they don't form H plus ion, they don't form any other type of ion in the solution. So they don't have any free electron to move. Okay. Next, concentration of H3O positive ion is affected when the solution of an acid is diluted. So tell me the reason. Disha was ready with the reason. Good. Yes, Neha is also correct. Correct. Good. So how you have to write this in the proper way, see here. See, hydrogen ion do not exist in the solution independently. Ion do not exist as H plus ion in the solution. Why? Because it's unstable, right? They react with the polar, they react with polar water molecule to form hydronium ion, right? How does it happen? H plus plus H2O gives H3O positive, right? So when a solution of acid is diluted, the number of H3O positive ion per unit decreases, right? So when a solution of acid is diluted, the number of H3O positive ions per unit volume decreases, right? Decreases. Thus, pH of the solution what? Thus, pH of the solution increases. Okay, now what are the keywords here you have to mention? This paragraph is very important. You have to mention in your solution. Okay. Right. Okay. Next. Now you are provided with the three test tube A, B and C, or maybe C, A and B, which contains distilled water, acidic solution and basic solution. If you are given with a blue litmus paper only, how will you identify the content of each test tube? The question came in 2015. You have three test tubes, and all three test tubes are containing, each one of them are containing distilled water. Then second one is acidic solution and the basic solution, right? So how will you identify the characters of all the solution with just only one litmus paper, blue? Any guess, any idea? Okay, I'm writing it here, okay? Okay, Yes. Correct. So the answer should be, you can write in this way. The first, we have to take three strips of blue litmus paper and dip one in each test tube. Take all three strips of blue litmus paper. Very good. And dip one in each tube. Right? So the liquid in test tube A, the first point, second point, the liquid in test tube A turns blue litmus to red. Right? What does it mean? It means the test tube A contains acid. Test tube A contains acid. Why? Because acid turned blue to red, right? Blue litmus paper to red, ABR. Correct. If other two test tubes do not show change in color. Now, if other two test tubes do not show change in blue litmus paper, in color, that means what? Both of them must be containing a base or neutral solution, right? Correct.
So a blue litmus paper dipped in a basic neutral solution will have no change.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Who was that?
Ma'am, it was Meghna.
Hi, Meghna.
Hi.
Your question was actually good. If suppose you have blue litmus paper, right? But if you put it into the neutral solution, then what will happen? It should change. It should show the change in color, right?
Yeah, ma'am, that's what I thought.
Yeah, no, that will happen only. If you have a blue litmus paper, then it will show the change in color. Correct. So once, if it is changing the color into red, that means you have acidic solution. If your one test tube, if it is showing no change in color, that means what? We don't know which color is there, like which liquid is there, right? If the one which is turning it into green, okay, that means you have neutral solution. Okay, that means you have neutral solution.
So blue litmus does change color.
Yes, in does change. Neutral solution does change the color of blue litmus paper.
All right, ma'am.
Yeah. 1 second, so many messages are there, ma'am. Who is this? I didn't see your name. Aryan, actually you are right. They should write that respectively. Okay, but if they have not written now, then you have to, like, by default, you need to understand that the first one is having the first thing. C is having distilled water, and A is having acidic solution, and B is having basic solution. Okay. sometimes there must be some, printing mistake, but obviously they are not going to consider it. We have to consider it, right? Okay. Yeah. Okay. So I think I have to correct it here. If other two test tube do not show change in color. No. If the one test tube, let's say, if test tube C changes its color from blue to green. Okay, that means what? It is your neutral solution. So I should write here means it is neutral solution. Right? And if you are the last test tube, B does not show a change in color, that doesn't mean it is only the basic solution. Okay, you have to cross check. How will you cross check? You can use this strip of test tube A, which has turned into red. Okay, so your test tube B will turn red color of that acidic litmus paper into blue. Did you understand what I'm trying to say? Okay. Guys, understood what I'm saying? Yeah? Okay. Now, put red litmus paper in test tube B. If it is not showing any change in color, oh my God, I don't have enough space. If it does not show change in color of blue litmus paper. Okay. Now you must be thinking red. From where will you get the red litmus paper? The red litmus paper turned red by acid. Turn red by acid. Okay, turn red by acid. We have to put, and then it changes from red to blue. Excuse me. Color of red paper changes to blue. Okay, which indicates the presence of basic solution in test tube B. Okay. Sorry, I don't have enough space. No, Aryan, no, it won't be purple in neutral solution, beta. No, it will turn from blue to slightly, it will turn to greenish blue. Okay.
But that's universal indicator, right?
That the universal pH strip we are talking about.
Ma'am, here we are talking about litmus paper, right?
Oh my God. Yeah. Correct. Yeah, correct. Sorry, my mistake, guys. I forgot we are talking about litmus paper. I was just assuming the pH strip. Yeah, correct. I did that experiment with the pH strip, but here we are talking about litmus paper. Yes. So, yes, correct. That's why the thing here, what I have written now, if we don't see any change in color, that means because we are using litmus paper, so it won't turn from blue to green. Even it won't turn blue to very bright purple. the change in color, to identify the change in color would be difficult. So again, you need to, what will you find? If you have two test tubes C and B, and if you're using blue litmus paper in the both the test tube, then there will be no color change. Okay. So what you have to do, you have to use the red strip, that red strip, which has turned red by the acidic solution in test tube C also. Okay, so let's say you have two test tubes here. Guys, sorry for the confusion because I even forgot that we are talking about litmus paper. Yes, here you have C, here you have A, and here you have, let's say, B. So here we are using blue litmus paper. 1 minute, I'm not able to see your messages. Blue litmus paper, it will turn to red. Here also we are using blue litmus paper and here again blue litmus paper. Okay, but no color change. Here also no color change. Here also no color change. Yes, Aryan, I'll come to this point. Okay, so see, no color change. Why I am writing no color change here? Because the change in color, to identify the change in color, is very difficult here. It doesn't change into bright purple color. Okay, if suppose, because they have not clearly mentioned you with how much acidic solution do you have, very strong, weak acid, what? If you have a strong acid, then you will get the intense blue color, right? And blue and purple, there is not a very big difference. Okay, so you can't assume or you can't be very sure that C is containing the neutral solution. You have to cross-check it. Okay, you have to cross-check. Yes, Surya, one litmus paper is enough, but by any chance, if it get wet, like very deeply wet, then what will you do? So be safer side you have to take now. See, one you have to take here, one you have to take here, correct? Then you found no change, then you use the red litmus paper of this here, okay? And again, no change, then you use red litmus paper of this here. Then definitely here you will get change the red into blue. Right, Surya? Okay. Yes, that was the good discussion. Done? Done with this question? Okay, good. Next. Now let's talk about salt. Yes, thanks for reminding me. Yeah, we were talking about litmus paper and I was assuming the universal pH strip. Next, neutral salt. Okay, neutral salt, what do we, salt. First of all, salt. Basically, what is the salt? Salt is what? Salt is the ionic compound, right? Which dissociate to form ions, correct? Ionic compound, which dissociate to form ions, right? We have different types of salt. Sodium chloride, the neutral salt, then acidic salt, basic salt. So, as neutral salts are usually formed by the combination of strong acid and strong base. They have pH approximately 7. Acidic salt formed by the combination of a strong acid and weak base. Okay, they have pH less than 7, obviously, right? And basic salt is strong formed by the combination of a strong base and weak acid, which has pH more than 7. Very common thing, we all know very well, right? Let me just think what I have. I was thinking to explain you here. Any question, anybody? No? Somebody was unmuted. No? Okay. So yes, neutral salt, acidic salt and basic salt. In upcoming slides, we will see how to write the answer for to identify or to explain the acidity or basicity of the salt. Okay, suppose if I am saying NaHCO3, why NaHCO3 is a basic salt? How will you explain it? How can you tell me that, yes, it is a basic salt? What is the reason? Okay. Shreyas, apart from this, beta. Apart from this, any other thing? Aryan? Anirudh, any other thing? How can you tell me that weak acid, weak base gives you neutral salt, beta? Neutral salt, okay? The pH would be approximately 7. Neutral salt, yeah. Okay, I'm getting answers. Yes, yes. Okay. Any other answer for this? Anirudh, are you there? Shobita, Momita, are you there? Okay, see here, I'm writing the answer and how you need to understand this question. Okay, how you have to write the answer for this type of question. This is what? This is the salt of weak acid. What is that? Carbonic acid, CO3. And strong base. What is that? NaOH, right? Weak acid and strong base, okay? Now, you know what happens after dissociation, okay? After dissociation in water or after reacting with water, NaHCO3 plus H2O, it forms Na positive HCO3 negative plus water, okay? Now, you know what happens? This HCO3 minus reacts with water. HCO3 minus reacts with water and it forms what? It forms carbonic acid again. So what it is giving? H2CO3 plus Na plus. What is remaining? OH minus is remaining. Correct. So see, in end of the reaction, what do you have? You have OH negative ion concentration, right? OH negative ion concentration. That's why sodium bicarbonate is basic in nature because it produces OH negative ion in the solution. Now, what is the reason? The reason is the carbonic ion, hydrogen carbonate hydrolyzed with water. Okay? HCO3 negative ion hydrolyzed with water. With water to produce what? To produce carbonic acid. Okay. And water to produce carbonic acid and OH negative ion. Okay. Sodium ion does not hydrolyze with water. Okay, so it doesn't hydrolyze, that means it doesn't form any OH. That's why you have OH negative ion concentration in water, which indicates the basicity of the solution. So presence of OH negative ion indicates basic character of NaHCO3. Understood, everybody? Got it? Everybody, got it? I just have received a message from Aryan and Shreyas. And we are total 72 here, 74, something like that. So you understood the meaning of hydrolysis, right? If suppose I ask that CH3COONA, why it is acidic, why it is basic in nature, how will you answer? In the same way, okay? Here we are using carbonic ion, there you have to use acetate ion. Acetate ion gets hydrolyzed by water to form acetic acid, okay? And it leaves behind OH negative ion concentration, right? Okay, moving to the next slide. Now we will see some important salts. The first one we have is sodium chloride. Okay, sodium chloride, you know, it's a very commonly known salt, common salt, correct? So first, what is the formula? Very well, we all are aware very well, right? Sodium chloride is NaCl. Occurrence of sodium chloride. Kulsum, okay, okay. Yes, I was talking about sodium chloride. So it's NaCl, the chemical formula is NaCl and common name, you know, common name. What is the common name? Caustic soda. Action on litmus paper. What is the action on litmus paper? It's neutral, right? See, nobody is paying attention, right? Nobody is paying attention. I have written caustic soda, but nobody said that, ma'am, sodium chloride is not caustic soda. Guys, what are you doing? You sleeping? Seriously, is that the class getting very bored? Akshita, okay, beta, don't get confused. Be confident. Don't get confused. Okay, you guys are done with your pre-boards. You have learned everything. This is the additional revision for you. So you have to be confident in your answers, in your concepts. Okay, if there is any confusion, if there is something, I will make it clear. Don't worry. Tell me, but after a long time, I just got a message from Aryan about this caustic soda. Okay, so guys, please be aware and just refresh your mind and then sit in the class. If you want to go and just take a round of your house or your nearby area, just go take it and then come back. But if you are here, you have to be here with complete presence of mind. Okay. Okay, the common name of this is what? Rock salt or common salt. Okay. Common salt. Action on litmus paper, neutral. Solubility in water, highly soluble. Highly soluble, right? Occurrence. It occurs in seawater. Occurrence I'm writing here. Occurrence is important for you, okay? It's given in NCERT as well. Occurrence, seawater. How much it contain? Almost 3%, right? Approximately 3% of NaCl, right? Next. Water of inland lakes like Sambar Lake, okay? Sambar Lake. Where we can get the Sambar Lake? In Rajasthan. Where do we have it? In Rajasthan, okay? Rock salt is more with impurities and common salt, Beta Surya. It's not very different. Sambar Lake in Rajasthan. Then, salt mines, right? Last is salt mines. Okay, yes, done. Okay. So everything is mentioned here also. Next. Important chemicals which we get from sodium chloride. So the first is sodium hydroxide. How do we prepare sodium hydroxide? By the help of chloralkali process. The process to prepare sodium hydroxide commercially at the industrial purpose, that is known as chloralkali process. See, the name itself indicates chlorine and alkali. Okay, that means in this process you get chlorine and alkaline solution in the end. Okay, so chloralkali process is because we get chlorine and a base as in the result in the product. Okay, yeah. NaCl, what is this? What is the chemical reaction? Overall chemical reaction is what? NaCl plus H2O gives Cl2 plus H2 plus important compound NaOH, right? If I balance it, then it should be 2, 2, and 2, right? Okay, so this is the chloralkali process. Now, you must have a diagram in your textbook, but actually you don't need that diagram. What is the important thing here you have to keep in your mind? You know, you get chlorine in this process. You get chlorine at anode, and you get hydrogen at cathode. So what does it mean? When you pass electricity from the brine solution, okay? When you pass electricity from the brine solution, what is brine solution? The concentrated sodium chloride solution. Concentrated sodium chloride solution. Concentrated NaCl solution. Okay, when you pass electricity from the brine solution, it converts into chlorine, hydrogen and NaOH. Right? Now chlorine we get at anode and hydrogen we get at cathode. Okay, you know what? On passing electric current through the solution of like a brine solution, hydrogen ion discharge more easily at cathode. Hydrogen ion discharge more easily at cathode. Okay, as compared to which more positive ion do we have? As compared to sodium, okay, right? And there it gains electron to convert into what? Hydrogen, right? So what is the reaction there? What is the reaction do we have at cathode and anode? The reaction at cathode and anode we have, it's something like this. H plus gains one electron to form H. This H is unstable, react with another hydrogen atom to form H2, right? At anode. Guys, I'm not able to see your messages right now, so please wait. Anode, H plus ion, at anode, chlorine it forms, right? At anode, we get chlorine. So Cl negative reaches to anode first as compared to OH negative, okay? So Cl negative loses one electron to form chlorine. Chlorine reacts with one more atom of chlorine to form Cl2, okay? That's how you get chlorine at anode and hydrogen gas at cathode. Now, what is the remaining in your solution? Na positive and OH. They both react together to form what? NaOH. Okay, understood? What is the use of NaOH? It is highly used base, right? Multipurpose industrial process may we use it. And then what is the another important use? In formation of soap and detergent. Soap and detergent. Okay. Any other question related to sodium chloride and sodium hydroxide related to this process, chloralkali process? Did you understand? Okay. Now, see, the chlorine, what we get from here, we have different uses of this chlorine. The most important use of this chlorine is what? The formation of bleaching powder. Okay, so you know what? The manufacturing plant of anyway, sodium hydroxide. Okay, you have, if you have a plant of sodium hydroxide, definitely that manufacturing plant must be connected with the plant of bleaching powder. Okay, our bleaching powder should be produced in the same plant. Why? Because all the chlorine produced in the process of sodium hydroxide can be consumed. Isn't it? Right? Right? Okay. Next. See here the diagram, this is given in your textbook as well. Hydrogen we get at cathode and chlorine we get at anode. Okay, simple, right? This hydrogen gas we can use as a fuel. Okay, in the formation of ammonia for fertilizer. This chlorine gas we can use in PVC as in disinfectants. But chlorine purely we can't use as a disinfectant. We have to form bleaching powder and then we can use it as a disinfectant. Okay, yeah. And yes, we use in water treatment as in the form of bleaching powder, right? So when this chlorine, when it forms the chlorine, right? It reacts with what? Calcium oxide, correct? It reacts with what? Calcium oxide, is it? How do it form bleaching powder? Guys, chlorine react with calcium hydroxide. Forgot everything, huh? Chlorine reacts with calcium hydroxide and it forms CaOCl2, okay? Calcium oxychloride. This is your formula of bleaching powder. We are going to discuss it. Okay, next. Another important chemical is what? Bleaching powder, right? How do we prepare bleaching powder? It is prepared by the action of calcium hydroxide with chlorine, okay? So you can say that bleaching powder can be prepared by the action of dry slaked lime with the action of chlorine gas, which we are obtaining from the chloralkali process. Okay. So it forms calcium oxychloride and water. This is your bleaching powder. Dry slaked lime. With chlorine, we get from chloralkali process and it gives calcium oxychloride. So don't get confused by the name, okay? Calcium, if it comes in your exam also, oxychloride, right? Okay. What is the, like, how does it looks like? What is the properties of bleaching powder? Have you seen it? I think you must have used it somewhere. Yeah? It looks like yellowish white powder, right? Yellowish. Very good, Aryan. Yellowish white powder. Second, what happens when we expose this into air? What happens when exposed to air? It reacts with carbon dioxide. Okay, it reacts with carbon dioxide. So CaOCl2 plus CO2, what it gives? CaCO3, calcium carbonate plus chlorine gas. Okay. Okay, now, yes, very good, Aryan. Very good, correct. Good observation. When we expose into air, we get some chlorine smell, right? The smell of chlorine. Why? Because it gives chlorine after reacting with carbon dioxide. It gives chlorine. Here I have written. Okay. Now, important thing I'm going to ask. What is the responsible for the bleaching action of bleaching powder? Which thing is responsible? And, okay, what do you say that... Aryan, what is the technical term? available chlorine. Okay, see, pay attention. I'm writing here the amount of chlorine liberated is called available chlorine. Okay, as the bleaching action depends on the available chlorine content the greater available chlorine is give you the better quality, right? So greater chlorine amount, better is the quality. Okay, hence higher the price, obviously, right? In India, always a good quality product is available in higher price, right? Higher the price. So, okay, leave it. So a good sample of bleaching powder should contain how much of the chlorine? Yes, Surya, that is also true. Okay, yes, good quality actually. Yes, better is the quality. So a good sample of bleaching powder contains 35 to 38% of chlorine. Oops. 35 to 38% of chlorine. Wait. Okay, or I should say available chlorine. Okay, next. Yes, the uses, you know very well, it's very common use in textile industry for the bleaching purpose of the clothes, and then in the laundry we use this as a disinfectant. Okay, so there are so many uses of bleaching powder. Okay, bleaching powder is good, a good kind of oxidizing agent. Okay, yeah, okay, next. Next we have, baking soda. My favorite, I love this. Okay, so common name of baking soda is what? Sodium hydrogen carbonate. Very well known, correct? And a preparation, how can we prepare it? You know what? NaCl with water, the concentrated NaCl solution is known as brine solution, correct? And if you have ammonia also in that, then this is known as what? Ammonical brine solution, correct? Yeah, so when carbon dioxide gas is passed, CO2 is passed through ammonical brine solution. ammonical brine solution. It produces sodium bicarbonate and ammonium chloride. Okay, sodium bicarbonate and ammonium chloride. So sodium chloride plus water is the brine solution, plus ammonia, it is ammonical brine solution. And when you pass carbon dioxide through this ammonical solution, it gives you sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate, and ammonium chloride. Okay, ammonium chloride. Now on heating, what happens? On heating of this sodium bicarbonate, it converts into sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate is again very important for us. Okay, right? We are going to learn about it, right? Now on heating, sodium bicarbonate produces sodium carbonate, water, and carbon dioxide. So this carbon dioxide produces, or this carbon dioxide causes the fluffiness in cakes, pastries, okay, in cookies, in doughs, right? That's why we add soda in pakodas, in cakes, in pastries, in so many things, okay, because it releases CO2. And we use sodium bicarbonate as in fire extinguisher as well, if I remember it right. Am I right? Aryan, am I right? Akshita, who all are available? Shobhita? Do we use sodium bicarbonate as in fire extinguishing? Right? Okay. Hmm. So Shobhita, you are here. It shows me your presence. Okay. Next. Yes. So we use in household purpose, obviously in household ingredients. Yes, ingredient of antacid. Okay. Making baking powder. What is the content of baking powder? What is the content of baking powder? Baking soda plus acid. But which acid? It is tartaric acid. Baking powder is mixture of what? Mixture of baking soda and mild acid. Which is known as tartaric acid. Okay, guys, I have seen a question in past year question list that what is the use of tartaric acid in baking powder, and why do we prefer to add baking powder instead of baking soda? Any guess? Sucharita Karthik. Sucharita, hi. First time I saw your message here, beta. Yes. Yes, Surya. Correct. Why do we prefer to use baking soda over sodium bicarbonate? Because tartaric acid controls the bitter taste of sodium carbonate. Okay, sodium carbonate. First thing. And it produces a good amount of, presence of acid produces a good amount of carbon dioxide. Yes. Very good, Aryan. Correct. It neutralizes the sodium carbonate. Very good. Good, Disha Ananya. Very good. Correct. Next. One more thing. Let me just think what I was... Yes. What is the name of the process by which we prepare this baking soda? The process name is Solvay process. Okay. Solvay process. This process, what we are following here, okay? This is known as Solvay process, or you can say ammonia soda process, or ammonia soda process, okay? Solvay process or ammonia soda process. No, Aryan. No. This is the Solvay process. When you pass ammonical brine solution from carbon dioxide, this is the Solvay process. Okay. And chloralkali process, when you pass electricity from brine solution.
You all please hold as Shanta ma'am will be joining in some time.
Hello everyone, hope I'm audible now. Am I audible now? Okay. Okay. Yes, actually some power fluctuation happened. So I'll share my screen again, 1 minute. 1 second. Tavishi, Tavishi, beta, you are the host. Can you please make me the host? Tavishi, can you hear me? Are you there? This is another problem. Tavishi. Yeah, thank you. Okay, thank you. Okay, let's continue. Now I can share my screen. So yes, we were talking about washing soda. We were talking about actually sodium bicarbonate. And now let's talk about washing soda. Washing soda is what? Washing soda is just sodium carbonate with 10 water molecule attached in it, right? With water of crystallization, right? Yeah, okay. No problem, Tavishi, thank you. Okay, so yes. Preparation, how will we prepare washing soda? By recrystallization of sodium carbonate, okay? This 10 water molecule, what do we say this? This is known as water of crystallization, okay, right? Now uses, we use in the glass, soap, paper industry, okay? We use to prepare in soda glasses actually. We use in the cleaning agent, in the domestic purpose, removal of the hardness of water. That's again very important use of washing soda, right? And, yes, we use that in the manufacturing of borax, okay? Sodium borate or boric acid, borax, okay? Yeah, you know, Na2CO3, this is sodium bicarbonate and this is also known as soda ash, soda ash. And what is the common name of KOH? Caustic potash, okay? Caustic potash, right? So don't forget these common names, right? Okay. Next, how can it react with the hard water? How can it remove the hardness of water? You know the hardness of water is due to the presence of what? Due to the presence of calcium and magnesium salt. Calcium and magnesium salt. Wait, I'm not able to see your messages. Calcium and magnesium carbonate salts, basically. Salt. So, on adding Na2CO3, what happens? They are precipitated as a calcium and magnesium carbonate salts. Adding CaCO3, adding NaNO3, they precipitate into CaCO3 and MgCO3, which is insoluble in water. And we can separate it. Correct. And we can remove the permanent hardness of water. Right? We can remove the permanent hardness of water. Okay. Now, how will you check the softening of water? If your water has softener now, it's become softer now, then it will start forming leather with water, leather with soap. Okay. Hard water doesn't form leather with soap. Okay. Next. Next, we have water of crystallization. What does it mean by water of crystallization? The fixed number of water molecule present in the one formula unit of a salt, that is known as water of crystallization. Okay. For example, on heating copper sulfate, water droplets appear. The formula of hydrated copper sulfate is what? CuSO4.5H2O. So when we heat it, this water will remove. Okay. This water will remove. Usually it is blue in color. Blue in color. So when you heat it, what happens? It converts into white. White in color. Why? Because it converts into CuSO4, which is white in color. Okay. Next, what is the example of water of crystallization formula in salt? Gypsum. CaSO4.2H2O. CaSO4.2H2O, right? On heating gypsum at 100 degrees Celsius or at 373 Kelvin, it becomes CaSO4.5H2O, which is the formula of plaster of Paris. Right? Which is the formula of what? Plaster of Paris. Now, you know that plaster of Paris is used in plastering the fractured bone. Correct? So, when plaster of Paris is mixed with some water, it forms gypsum. Or when you leave plaster of Paris in the environment, it becomes hard. Why? Because it reacts with atmospheric moisture and it converts into gypsum. Right? So, CaSO4.5H2O. In POP, you have a half water molecule, okay? Okay, you have half water molecule in just one formula of POP, okay? So when it react with 1.5 water molecule, not actually 1.5, when it react with half, sorry, 1.5 only, 1.5 water molecule, it forms CaSO4.2H2O, which is the formula of gypsum, right? Gypsum. Okay, use of plaster of Paris is what? Making toys, decorative materials, smoothen the surfaces, right? Okay, now we are going to start doing some questions, okay? So, next question we have. The blue color of crystal of the substance changed on heating in a closed test tube, but the color was regained after some times on cooling it. So, can you just tell me what is this blue color of material? Which material do we have? Very good. So now not only CuSO4, guys, please don't send me half of answers, yaar. Surya, there are now questions and only questions remaining. So we'll do just few questions and after that we will be doing a passage related question. Okay. There are so many questions. So if you want, I can pose this presentation and learn is the question presentation. Okay, don't worry, the chapter revision is got over. Only a few questions are there. So that you can do by your own as well. Okay, don't worry. Yes, the blue color salt name is what? CuSO4.5H2O. Okay, what is the reaction? The CuSO4.2H2O, when it gets heated, it converts into what? It converts into CuSO4 plus 5H2O. And on cooling it, it reacts with atmospheric oxygen or atmospheric moisture and it again gains the blue color. So this is what CuSO4.5H2O. Okay, so we have to name the substance and write the chemical formula. What is the name of the substance? Copper sulfate. Okay, name of the substance is what? Copper sulfate crystal. Crystal. And formula, you know this one. This you have to write in bracket, correct? Which turns from blue to white. which turn from blue to white, okay? And again, which turn from white to blue after exposure into moisture. Done? Okay, next. Write the name and chemical formula of two such compounds whose one formula unit associated with 10 and 2 water molecule. 10 and 2 water molecule, okay? Tell me any crystal, any form of the crystal in which you have 10 and 2 water molecule. Quickly. Example, the first example, you can give me washing soda. Na2CO3.10H2O. Then another example, you can give me gypsum. Right? CaSO4.2H2O. Correct? And you have to write their chemical name. Sodium carbonate dihydrate, decahydrate, sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate is decahydrate. And calcium sulfate dihydrate. Calcium sulfate dihydrate. Okay, decahydrate and dihydrate you have to mention. Okay, next. A student was given with the 4 sample of water in the 4 different test tube. These were distilled water, lemon water, and water having dilute HCl. Okay, fine. Water having NaOH also. Which sample pH value will be more than 7? Will be 7, sorry. Which sample value will be 7? B, yes, correct answer. Good, right? Good, next. If the pH of the solution changes from 3 to 4, the solution becomes? Very good, less acidic. Next, the name of the scientist who proposed the acid-base theory. Very good. A, Arrhenius has proposed acid-base theory. Now, please see here. The theories are not there in your NCERT portion, but the question was there in 2016 paper. Okay, so always you need to learn little extra. That is not bad. Okay. Next, name of the gas evolved in zinc metal react with HCl. Very good, D, correct. What is the important property of the of an antacid? Of an acid, it's sour in taste, correct. Good, very good, next. When a drop of unknown solution X is placed on the strip of pH paper, a deep blue color is produced. This solution B? Very good, guys. NaOH, correct. On diluting an acid, advice to add acid to water. Do not add water to acid. Explain why. You can explain me. You can tell me in short. Very good. Okay. The on diluting an acid, advice to add acid to water, not water to acid. Why? Because it is highly exothermic process. I am writing in short because we do not have that much of time. I am writing just the important and keywords. Okay. You have to include this keyword in your sentences because it is highly exothermic process. Okay, when water is added to acid, due to the small amount of water, the heat is evolved. Okay, we'll change it into the vapor, right? So acid will spill out. And acid will spill out. Okay? And may cause injury. injury. So it is advisable to mix acid into water, not water into acid. Okay, done? Understood? See, these are the keywords you have to include. Exothermic, acid will spill out. It may cause injury. These you have to include in your answers. Okay, next. A student adds a spoonful of powdered sodium powdered sodium hydrogen carbonate in the flask containing ethanoic acid. Okay, list any two main observations. Okay, so the two observations. The first observation I'm writing is gives brisk effervescence. It gives brisk effervescence. Okay, with a colorless and odorless gas. With a colorless and odorless gas. Okay, second observation. You have to write two observations. Good. Actually, both the observations I have written in the first point only. The gas would be colorless and odorless. It produces a gas which is colorless and odorless, and it gives a brisk effervescence. Okay. Okay. So this is the answer for this one. But you have to write a chemical equation. CH3COOH plus NaHCO3 gives CH3COONa plus H2O plus CO2. Okay, this is the equation. Okay, guys, I wanted to know one thing. I wanted to know one thing from you. The next chapter, we are going to start metals and non-metals. And what would you prefer? Just revising past year questions or theory and past year questions, both the revision you want? Like how we have done in acid basis. If you can hear me, please answer what Ananya is saying, past year questions. I need the opinion of everyone in this. Okay. Okay, so I have got 50-50%. Okay. Okay, Aiden, thank you for all of your opinions. Yes, so guys, we will be doing both actually, first theory and then past year questions. Okay, so from the next time now, I will not write answers here. Okay, I will just write answer like maybe in my notebook or somewhere, and I'll just upload the photo. That will be more time saving for all of you, right? Okay. Prashmi, okay, fine. Thank you, Beta. Okay, next. The white powder is an active ingredient of antacid, that you know. We can leave it. Let the equation show effect of heat on this compound. Okay. You know this question. I know. Leave it. Okay, let's do that passage type of question, which is here. A solid compound X on heating gives carbon dioxide and a solid residue. The residue, when mixed with water, it forms Y. On passing of excess of carbon dioxide through Y, water is clear solution and Z is obtained. So you have to tell me what is X, Y, and Z. No. The first one, what is identify X? What is X? Aaron, but nahi beta, it can't be NaHCO3. Yes, Aaron, now it is correct. CaCO3 and why is no. Think once again. See, the first one is calcium carbonate. Second one is your calcium hydroxide. Okay. One second, guys. Yes, correct. Yes, correct. Okay. And then the last one is, that is what? That is what? That is this one, CaHCO3, isn't it? Because this is soluble in water, right? So many of you have answered me for first and second. What about the third one? Yes, this is the A, okay? This is soluble in water. So third answer Z is what? CaHCO3 twice, okay? When you pass excess of carbon dioxide from the calcium hydroxide, it converts into calcium bicarbonate. Okay, next. Assertion and reason. Assertion and reason may, okay, because here you have option. Option A, both the assertion and reason are true. And the reason is the correct explanation. Okay, B is what? Both assertion and reason are true, but the reason is not the correct explanation. Okay, and in C, assertion is true, but reason it false. And in D, both assertion and reason are false. So now just check. Phenolphthalein is an acid, and acid base indicator. The phenolphthalein gives different color in acidic and basic medium. A? No, it's A beta. A, correct, right? The answer for this is A. Assertion and reason both are correct, and the reason is the correct explanation of assertion. Okay, second, pH of the ammonium nitrate solution is acidic. pH of ammonium nitrate solution is acidic. The solution of salt is a weak base and strong acid. What should be the answer for this? So for second, again A, okay? pH of ammonium nitrate solution is acidic, right? Is it? What's happening? So many messages. No. See, phenolphthalein is acid-base indicator, right? They just have told acid-base indicator. If it is colorless, then it is acidic. And if it is a pink in color, it is a base. So it is acid-base indicator. You have to be very specific with the words, right? Ralph, for you are saying answer C for the third one, really? No, for third one, it is D, I guess. So pH 7 signifies, not only signifies pure water, pH 7 signifies neutral solution. Okay, that's why assertion itself is false. And pH of acetic acid is greater than 7. No, it is less than 7. So it is D. Okay. And for second one, it is A. Solution of ammonium nitrate is the acidic. Why? Because it is the combination of weak base ammonium hydroxide and strong acid, that is nitric acid. Correct, right? Okay. Got it, everyone? Understood all the assertion and reason? No, Shaduli, actually see, pH 7 doesn't signify pure water only. Okay, it signifies the neutral solution. It doesn't matter that pH 7 if you have, that will always be water. No, that will be neutral solution. If you have a pure water, that means pure water is a neutral solution. That's why this assertion is false. Okay, yeah. Okay, guys, so now we are done with these questions. I will write all the answers of these questions and upload in the Learnist. All these questions. How many questions are left? I guess 5 questions are left. Okay. And in the next class, we will be doing metals and non-metals theory in 1 hour and the next 1 hour questions. Fine? Okay. How was the lecture, guys? Did you enjoy? Did you understand everything? Acid and bases was the biggest chapter. Yeah. It was too big. Okay, guys, good. Chalo, enjoy. Who was there?
Ma'am, I am Shivani.
Shivani, beta, I'll talk to you later. You can send me a message in WhatsApp, okay?
Ma'am, in your personal contact?
Yes, you have that. Oh. I can send you over there, yeah.
Okay, ma'am, thank you very much for this lecture.
Okay, everyone. Chalo. Bye, guys. Bye. Take care. Enjoy. Bye-bye. Welcome, bacha. Bye. Welcome, beta. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye, guys. Yeah. Thank you. Bye-bye.